Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Amen. If you can stand to your feet, amen. Grab your Bibles. Are you excited about what God is going to do?
Hallelujah.
Amen. If you would turn with me to Psalm 29. Amen. We're going to start this way today. Is that all right?
Amen.
Amen. Psalms 29. And so God just wanted to set the atmosphere, amen, for what he's doing today. Amen. This is a kingdom takeover. Amen. Religion has been paralyzed, amen. And so this scripture God gave me this morning, actually late last night into this morning, and he just wanted to let you know about his voices that are coming today, amen.
Yes.
And he's going to start out talking about what his voice can do. Y'all ready for that? Amen. So when God anoints the vessels to come up here and use their voices, they're actually being summoned by God, amen, to release his voice, amen. So let's read Psalm 29, amen. A psalm of David. Give unto the Lord, O you mighty ones. Give unto the Lord glory and strength. Give unto the Lord the glory due to his name. Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. The voice of the Lord is over the waters. The God of glory thunders. The Lord is over many waters. The voice of the Lord is powerful. The voice of the Lord is full of majesty. The voice of the Lord breaks the cedars. Yes, the Lord splinters the cedars of Lebanon. Why the cedars of Lebanon? He said that the cedars in Lebanon are very aromatic. In other words, they have a fragrance about them. But also the cedars of Lebanon are the type of tree that it is. It is the most resistant tree in any of the trees that God has planted. So what he's saying is, even the most resistant things, I'm gonna break it through. My God. The things that was trying to stand in the midst of things, I'm gonna break through it. My voice is gonna do that. So when God is releasing his voices today, it's gonna break through some religious mindsets, some churchy things, and God said, I'm gonna break through even the thing that is resisting me. Y'all hear that? Woo. Verse number 6, he makes them also skip like a calf. There are some people that are gonna be released because the resistance has been broken through. God said, when I remove the resistance, even Lebanon is gonna skip like a calf. Did y'all catch that? He said, he makes them also skip like a calf, Lebanon and Syrian like a young wild ox. The voice of the Lord divides the flames of fire. The voice of the Lord shakes the wilderness. The Lord shakes the wilderness of Kadesh. Nothing that was able to be birthed, God said, I'm going to shake it, and it's going to allow my birthing to come forth. Amen. The voice of the Lord makes a deer give birth. Even his voice makes things begin to process, and things come forth, and things begin to break forth, and strips the forest bare. And in his temple, everyone says what?
Glory.
Say it again. And everybody in the temple say,
glory.
Amen. That means manifest yourself. Become waiting in this place. God, glory to you, God. You're going to manifest yourself in this place. Amen.
Yes.
The Lord sat enthroned at the flood, and the Lord sits as king forever. The Lord will give strength to his people. The Lord will bless his people with peace. My God. Somebody say, the voice of the Lord is strong.
The voice of the Lord is strong.
Can you just lift your hands right now? Let's just take a moment. Hallelujah. Let's take a moment to decree and declare some things in the atmosphere. Amen. Come on, open up your mouth. Open up your belly to release the power of the Holy Ghost. Come on. God, we thank you in this place because you're setting the atmosphere for your voice. You are breaking through every point of resistance. God, you're breaking through minds that have been chained. We thank you, oh God, and decree you as king, and you sit enthroned over the waters. We thank you, oh God, because you're releasing voices in here today that's going to tear up some things. It's going to shake some things. It's going to empower some things. It's going to bring some people through wildernesses. God, we thank you that processes are going to be finished. Transition is going to come to its expected end. We decree and declare. Today is the day. This is the moment. This voice.
Thank you.
My, my, my. The voice of the Lord. Amen. At this time, we're going to ask that the God's anointed ones would come and minister to us through song. Amen. If you would come at this time, amen. Give them a hand as they come. Amen.
Have your way, have your way, have your way.
Amen. Give him another hand. Amen. That is our heart cry that the Lord will have his way. Amen. Amen. Are y'all ready for the word? Amen. The first voice, somebody say voice, that you will hear, amen, is coming from, amen, Elder Trina Smith, amen, awesome woman of God. I've known her now for almost 9 years, amen, and she is an elder at Victory Worship Center, amen, under an awesome woman of God, amen, Apostle Cynthia Brooks, amen. I'd like to give honor, amen, to where honor is due, amen, Apostle Cynthia Brooks, amen. Amen. And definitely, amen, not leaving out the man of God, amen, who has allowed us to use this facility, amen, to break through, amen. And that's Prophet Vini, amen. We're going to hear from him later on, amen. And definitely our visionaries, amen, Prophet Ralph and Prophetess Tracy Fauntleroy. I don't know what that was, amen. Hey, you don't know. It's apostolic in nature, isn't it? Try to clean that up. Amen. So we are excited, amen, for the first voice that God is going to use, amen. One thing I know about Elder Trina, and that is she has a passion and a heart for the invisible. Amen. What I mean by that, those are the people we overlook. We don't notice in the crowd. Amen. She is quick to figure out the needs of those who are invisible. Amen. And so what God uses her to do, amen, evangelistically, amen, and at times can be very prophetic. And as a teacher, amen, God uses her to show and pinpoint the people nobody else thinks about. Amen. Those are the people that she goes after. And God uses her voice to break through the barrier of invisibility. My God, in the communities, in the church, in the kingdom, God is calling for this voice to show us the invisible people, the people we don't see, the people we have not paid attention to. That is her heart. That is her passion. And so when you hear her voice, what you're going to hear is the voice of somebody pulling out those who are invisible into the light of God. Amen. And so I want you to stand to your feet and say, come on, voice of Elder Trina Smith. Amen. Use your voice. Amen.
Good morning, good morning, good morning. Okay, first thing I need for everybody to do for me is put your finger on your ear.
Amen.
I need you to speak a few things out before we start.
Amen.
Because this is what resonated through me all night long, that he who has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying. Say, come on ear.
Come on ear.
Come on ear.
Come on ear.
I need to hear.
I need to hear.
What the Spirit of the Lord is saying
for me.
Amen. 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 When I was dealing with this, and Prophetess Tracy called me, you know, after that, I didn't sleep anymore. I don't sleep. Y'all know, if anybody know me, my apostle and prophet and whoever heard me, y'all know I like a story. So I search for a story. Because I think a story will take your mind and place you in a different place than just simply hearing. It's going to be the scripture, but I'm going to give you a story. And I'm going to take you to what Jesus does, and I'm talking now because I'm coming from Matthew, and Matthew was one of the apostles, and Matthew's one of his missions was to take and talk about the parables of Jesus when Jesus would have to teach his disciples. And in here today, and what this thing that this move of God here is for the disciples, the leaders, the ones that are about to go forth and do the things that God has set forth for them to do, the leaders. So don't think it weird that you're here. God calls you here. Thank you, Mom. And when God said, he needed for me to remind you of some things. So because I'm watching the time. And I need you to very carefully listen to these words before I go into my story. And I want you to take these words this week and just put them, I want you to deposit them, take them, and put them in your spirit and watch as they come up in you this week, because that's what God said it's going to do. It's actually a song, but the song of the words were so strong, they resonated in my head last night. And when I woke up this morning, actually Michael English was on the TV singing the words of this song, and he had been through some stuff and he had come out of some stuff. So hear all the words and listen with your ear. There's a whole lot of stubbornness in this room. Point to yourself. In yourself. There's a whole lot of pride in this room. Myself. But there's nobody but me in this room. There's a molecule of faith in this room. Point to yourself. What they used to call a mustard seed and a book that says that's all I need. That's me. Even if it's much too small to see, I'll find the one that left it here for me. Now that's for you and that's for me. There's stubbornness and there's pride. Remember, there's molecules of faith. There's mustard seeds, and there's a book that's got all that you need. Remember that this week. So I'm gonna take you, I'm gonna give you a couple of scriptures. I'm gonna stay in Matthew 22, but I'm gonna let you write down these ones, because I'm gonna give you a story, because what I'm going to do is I'm gonna show you how the people of God need to have a gravitational pull. There's going to be a gravitational pull of church and kingdom. There's a gravitational pull of church and kingdom. Matthew 22, 1 through 14. Then it's Matthew 10, verse 11. And then it's Proverbs 9. Wisdom. Wisdom is the principal thing. Wisdom is a woman. And the parable in Matthew 22, it reads, "And Jesus answered and spoke to them again by parable and said, the kingdom of heaven is like a certain king who arranged a marriage for his son and sent out his servants to call those who were invited to the wedding, and they were not willing to come. He sent out other servants, saying, tell those who are invited, see, I have prepared my dinner, my ox and fatted cattle all are killed, and all things are ready. Come to the wedding." Remember that. Come to the wedding. "But they made light of it and went their ways, one to his own farm, another to his business, and the rest seized his servants, treated them spitefully, and killed them. And he sent out his armies, destroyed those murderers, and burnt up their cities. Then he said to his servants, the wedding is ready, but those who were invited were not worthy. Therefore, go to the highways, and as many as you find, invite them to the wedding. So those servants went into the highways and gathered together all those they found, both bad and good, and the wedding hall was filled with guests." We're going to stop right there for a minute. Because when I went to the Message Bible, I went over to the Message Bible, and the Message Bible was saying that when he told them, he said, "I'm having a wedding for my son." And he said, but he said, the ones that wouldn't come, when they wouldn't come, he said, "I want you to go over into the busy highways. I want you to go to the intersections." Bring the good and the bad. And tell them to come. He said, because the prime rib has been cut. Has been cut. See, there's a gravitational pull between church and kingdom. Because church has gotten so familiar with what they thought church should be that when they're hearing kingdom, it's so foreign to them, they're saying, they're making fun of it. They're making light of it. They're killing God's people, and they're saying, I'm going on to my business. I'm not coming today. I'm going to take care of business. That's not something. They make fun of it. But there are some that's in the intersection, the highways and the byways and the hedges that people forgot about, and the good and the bad and the indifferent, the ones that don't dress quite right, don't have quite enough money, but they were chosen. He said, many are called, but few are chosen. He said, I called you, but you won't work.
Come on now.
He said, so go to the intersection, those that are in between decisions on whether I want to live or I want to die, whether they ever recognize me or not, whether I want to go to this church or whether I just want to stay out here in this world, the intersection, good, bad, and indifferent. And then it says, 12, no, let's go to 11. But when the king, now mind you, there the guests have filled in. But when the king came in and to see the guests, he saw a man there who did not have on his wedding garments. So he said to him, friend, how did you come in here without your wedding garments? And he was speechless. Then the king said to his servants, he said, bind him hand and foot. Take him away and cast him into outer darkness. There will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. He said, for many are called, but few are chosen. You're probably thinking, well, the king, you know, being the king, he probably had, you know, probably had to have on this robe, certain robes and things like that. And he said, but we're not talking about a natural king. We're talking about the king that rules the kingdom. He said, kingdom is not meat and bread, apostle.
Come on.
But it's righteousness. Peace. Joy in the Holy Ghost. He said, where is your righteousness? Where is your peace? Where is your joy? And I don't see it because you have no Holy Ghost.